Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and for you who doesn't know who I am, my name is Alisa and I do a lot of makeup content here on my channel, and I'm also a cruelty-free YouTuber. And today I am going to talk about some things that I want to buy. So if you haven't been here for a while, or if you are new, I am currently in a no-buy that I think is going over to a low-buy in April. I'm not sure yet. I will see how I feel in the end of March, but I actually want to talk about today some things that I want to buy. I have six things that I want to buy, and it's mostly base products. I don't know what's happened to me, but like base products is my favorite thing right now. I got three foundations that I want to talk about. I don't know what happened. And actually only one eyeshadow palette and a skincare thing. And a lipstick. So I think we're just going into this. So I'm going to scooch a little bit because you are going to see pictures. So if I scooch, can you see my mess? Yes, you might. But okay, should we just power through the foundations? Maybe we should. So we can start with Milk. Okay, this is a skin tint, this is their Sunshine Skin Tint with SPF 30. I don't know what it is, but like skin tints and just something really nice to even it out. I want that. I want it so, so much. I have a skin tint from Glossier that I use to work some days. I think it's good, so I want to try something more. So I really want to try this. I don't know about the packaging though, because it feels like you are not getting much at all. When I have gone through some foundations and going to buy new ones, I think I will try this one when I want to try a new skin tint. I think I would buy this. It just, like the first little clip I saw on it on Instagram, I was like, I want it now. It's coming in February in the beginning. It's February when you see this. I don't know when it's coming to Sweden, but I can't buy it until April either way, so I'm cool with that. Next one is a new... Is this also a skin tint? Tinted Glow Hydrator from... Okay. It is the Stay Naked Hydro Manic Tinted Glow Hydrator from Urban Decay. I got the Stay Naked foundation that I really, really, really like. I think I'm like down to here maybe. Now it's been laying down, so... But yeah, I used this a lot. I really liked it. Like it. And this... But I guess this is a little bit more of a glowy, not that much coverage. And hello, here I am. I want it. I want it now. I don't know it has come to Sweden yet, even though Urban Decay said it was going to come to Sweden like in the beginning of January. But what I know, it hasn't come to Sweden yet. I know we can buy it from Cult Beauty, I think. But again, I'm in the no-buy, but this is also going to be mine someday. Someday this year, this is going to be mine. We will see when. Last foundation is from Body Shop. It's the Fresh Nude foundation. I got the Fresh Nude concealer that it's like the same line. I love this concealer. I actually have a little test on the foundation here. I haven't tried it yet because... What if I like it and then to know that I can't buy this foundation for a while, I'm going to be sad. But I really, really, really want to try this because the concealer is amazing. And some people that I've seen that like the same foundations that I do and want the same from a foundation as I do, they really like this Fresh Nude. So that makes me want it more. So this is also going to be mine someday. Don't know when. I think though the lightest shade is going to be too dark for me, but I can lighten up. It's no worries, but I think this... No, I don't know which one I'm most intrigued by. I think the Urban Decay, then this one, and then Milk. But yeah, this is also going to be mine someday. Next up, we maybe can take the skincare thing. I haven't said that I have a no-buy on skincare, but I should have it because I have a lot of skincare products. But this is also from the Body Shop, and they have come out with a new serie. They have come out with a lemon serie. I have bought the hand soap, and that is not for only me. It's for the household, so that is okay. But they have a purifying face wash. I really, really love the Body Shop's face washes. I think I've tried 4 or 5 different, and they all are really, really good. And this lemon serie is like antibacterial. Both like the hand soap and also this face wash, and I really, really am intrigued to use it. I want it, and when I gone through all my face washes I have now, I'm going to buy this one to try it, and I hope I will love it. And I think that this is vegan. Yes, it is. And I'm just so intrigued. When I was at Body Shop and bought the hand soap, I was like, maybe I can buy, but no. No more until I need it, when I need to buy a replacement. But this, have you tried it? Please tell me it's shit, so I don't want to buy it. Please. Then I also want to buy some lipsticks from Odin's Eye. I haven't tried anything from Odin's Eye yet. They just released pictures on their new collection. I like the eyeshadow palette, but I want to see like people use it before I make up my mind. But their new lipsticks. I really want the liquid lipsticks that they have, or like the lip stains that they have. But I also want these bullet lipsticks. Do I need them? Hell no. Do I want them? Oh yeah. I don't know what it is, but it just feels like they have my kind of colors. And yeah, when I'm going to, in the future, if I will buy from Odin's Eye, I know that I will buy lipsticks. Maybe through in the eyeshadow palette, but lipsticks is like, it's like base products of lips for me now. What is happening? Nobody knows. And the last thing that actually is an eyeshadow palette is the new palette from Nomad. It's the Iceland palette, and I have been to Iceland. It was the best vacation I have ever had. But yeah, this Icelandic palette, inspired by Iceland. I like it. I think though some of the like greenish lighter shades, maybe not all of them need to be in the palette, but I really like the color story that it is like two different sides on it. But I like the middle row that is like orange, because I love orange, and I love that it is a black in it. I think it's a black at least. And yeah, I just think that Nomad does really good color stories, and this is not an exception. And I guess that this will be mine. The only thing I don't super thrill about is the little gnome. You know what? The palette is called The Land of Fire and Ice. But to my defense, now during my no-buy, I'm like, I don't even want to look at the new things that comes out, because I don't want to like, I don't want to be tempted. But yeah, the Land of Fire and Ice. I guess in the future I will buy this, maybe to like Black Friday. It's February and I'm talking about November. But yeah, I think it looks good. And I have two palettes from Nomad and I think they do really like different things in their palette. I have the Nomad Tokyo Harajuku palette and the Orient Express, and the Tokyo Harajuku palette is a really like pastely light compliment palette for me, when the Orient Express is a standalone palette that has deeper shades, has really like impactful colors and everything. And I want to test more of their palettes just to see how they are, and this The Land of Fire and Ice is the most intriguing to me. Actually, I think it is. So yeah, this is also my wish list. But for the next 2 months, nothing is coming into my makeup life. So okay, that was all I want to talk about. I hope that you like this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do, so you don't miss any of my videos, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!